Continuing with our review, Christmas is synonymous with many popular artists, past and present. One that has captivated the ear of American women has also captivated their hearts. That man is Frank Sinatra. Starting his career in the 1930s, he helped us through the Great Depression and Second World War. However, in his album, A Frank Sinatra Christmas, he mixes talent with meaning, and that reminds us how Christmas is supposed to sound. Such songs as The Christmas Song and I'll Be Home for Christmas, he reminds us that all we need is just to spend Christmas with somebody that we love, and that is the true meaning. But also, who could forget the classic film by Irving Berlin, Holiday Inn? Starring Bing Crosby, Fred Astaire, and Marjorie Reynolds, they tap dance and sing their way through 13 holidays, one of which includes the famous holiday, Christmas, and includes the famous song by Bing Crosby himself, White Christmas, which won the Academy Award for the year 1953. 'Tis the season for one of the most traditional films of all time. We'll be back after a short break, so don't go away. Well, exactly 57 years ago, the Playboy Bunny icon was born. Back when Playboy called its home at 11 East Superior Street, Hugh Hefner had commissioned Art Paul to create a cool, sophisticated look for his magazine. But Hugh Hefner had also bigger plans for Art Paul. He had commissioned him to create a cool, sophisticated logo to signify that his magazine was like no other. Hefner, who chose the rabbit, chose it for its friskiness and playfulness. Hefner would later receive his wish. Art Paul had designed the rabbit wearing a smoking jacket and ascot while smoking a cigarette and holding a cocktail, the picture that you can see behind me right there. However, it would later change, which would be displayed on magazine covers and also present women. This would add to the sophistication and spice, which would later gain Playboy its recognition in its early years. But it would change to the symbol that we know today, which would be found at the ends of stories to signify that it was finished. But not only did the rabbit head symbol serve its purpose in the magazine, but also in and out of the Playboy clubs. Playboy waitresses would don the rabbit ears, collar, bow tie, and fluffy tail. But as the Playboy clubs ceased in 84, their kind wouldn't be around forever. But probably its highest fame reached when Hugh Hefner's black DC jet airline would don the rabbit head on the tail of the plane. Thus it was dubbed the Big Bunny back in 1964. However, the rabbit did not always have a pleasant time. During the Reagan administration, it was called out for a bunny hunt. It wouldn't be until the 1990s that the Playboy rabbit could come out of its rabbit hole and enter society to play once more. So, whether the icon would be on the full-body tuxedo, magazine, airplane, or the clubs, it has certainly left its mark in American history.
And in your room.
And in my room, that is very true. So,
during the Reagan administration, Playboy was discouraged greatly. Do you think you will get discouraged due to this?
Probably, but they only view it as that because they were taught that it was morally wrong. The reason that it was taught to be morally wrong by many people in society today was because of the dictionary definition that they read it from. Now, it is true, by dictionary definition, it states Playboy, a noun, somebody, a man, who spends most of his time in pleasure-seeking activities. However, that's not the case. Probably the best definition is by Hugh Hefner right here.
So, during the Reagan administration, Playboy was discouraged greatly. Do you think you would get discouraged due to this?
Yes, I think I will get discouraged doing this. But it's only because people think that way. By dictionary definition, they were taught that Playboy, noun, a man who spends much time in activity and pleasure-seeking However, that's not the case. Hugh Hefner, who originally made the true definition of a playboy in 1956, stated this, which I have right here. Is he simply a wastrel, a ne'er-do-well, a fashionable bum? Far from it, actually. He can be a sharp-minded business executive, a worker in the arts, a university professor. He can be many things, providing that he possesses a certain point of view. He must see life not as a veil of tears, but as a happy time. He must take joy in his work, without regarding it as the end of all of living. He must be an alert man, a man of sensitive pleasure, a man of sophistication, a man without acquiring the stigma of the voluptuary or the dilettante can live life to the hilt.
So really, he could be anyone, a policeman, a mayor?
Actually, yes, he could be anybody. For instance, Benjamin Franklin was a playboy of 1776. He was married. He actually was a very successful man, both here and in France, but he also had mistresses in both countries. But people didn't view him for that. They only looked up to him more due to the fact that, yes, he had taste in both women and culture, and accompanying that, he enjoyed life.
Like, live life to the hill, or sing like no one hears you?
Ah, you speak of the playboy philosophy, my dear. And that was written by Hugh Hefner, and was displayed in the early publications of Playboy. Now, this month, we are engaging in the importance of the individual from January 1965 Playboy issue. In this, it states that freedom is a birthright, that it is provided by every person and has their own rights in society, whether they are a black man or a black woman or a white man and a white woman. However, not only should he explore himself to find who he is, but that society should help him in his quest. This would and will help him learn to take pride in the kinship that links him from all others, past, present, and in the future. His interests are what make him paramount, and that we live in a society where we are encouraged to step out, to actually take the time and press time, to actually put ourselves in society and say, this is where I stand.
Well, right now it looks as if it's 11:40.
Well, we'll be back after a short break. Afterwards, we will return, so don't go away. Ladies and gentlemen, it's now time to stand and fill our glasses. So, with only ample time to spare for 2011, let's toast the new year out and toast the new year in. Here you are, my sir.
Thank you.
All right. You want to start the countdown, miss? I think it's only fair that you should, since you are the guest of honor tonight, our lady of the evening. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Happy New Year! Well, thank you for joining us on this very special New Year's Eve. I'm your host, Mark Summerville.
And I'm Shannon Barrier.
Happy New Year.
You more, no one else could love you more.
Playboy, Playboy logo, Playboy After Dark, Playboy magazine, Hugh Hefner, and any Playboy references belong to Playboy Enterprises, Chicago, Illinois, USA. Any Playboy merchandise is owned by Mark Summerville. This show is for non-profit reasons, and no merchandise are to be sold. No nudity featuring full chests or lower genital regions are allowed to be or permitted. No alcohol or tobacco was used in the making of this production. This disclaimer is the context for all 50 states and